use a face shield to protect both you and the client. Like me, it's been 14 years I'm in the makeup industry, and I started using a face mask 14 years ago. Hi everybody, welcome back to my channel, Chanelie767. Hope everybody's having a blessed day today. Today on the Makeup Artist Advisory by Chanelie767, we are going to talk about your sanitation and hygiene kit. So just a few disclaimers, everything I mentioned under this series is my personal experience being in the beauty industry for 14 years. And I just want to share with you all my tips, tricks, techniques, getting from point A to success. So sanitation makeup kit is mandatory in every makeup artist kit. Even if you're a freelance or a studio, it is mandatory for you to have a sanitation kit involved. So first on the list, of course, is your Barbersite training certificate. Now the Barbersite training certificate, guys, it is free on the site. Free, completely free. You just need to do a training for like a couple hours, and then you do a free exam, and then you get the certificate for free. They send it to you in your email. If you are in the spa industry, you're an esthetician, or you are a barber or a salon and a makeup artist, they have the Barbersite training certificate available for you. It's just to prove to your clients and yourself you understand why it is important to sanitize. Now the certificate, you don't necessarily need to walk around with, especially if you're a freelance makeup artist, but just at least to have with you, even in case your clients ask for it, you can show it to them on your phone, or if you are a studio makeup artist, you can have it hang out in your studio. Now the next point is having a mask and a face shield. It is mandatory for you to have, especially in the time of COVID. You can either use a mask or you can use a face shield to protect both you and the client. Like me, it's been 14 years I'm in the makeup industry, and I started using a face mask 14 years ago. So it's nothing new to me using a face mask, because I always tell myself I'm really that close all up in a client's face applying makeup application, and I always say, you know what, it's better to have a face mask because you're literally breathing in the client's face. Even if you are a distance and applying makeup, you're still up and close with her clients. So that's why I always say, for years, no matter what, I will always use a face mask or a face shield whenever I'm doing a makeup application. Then you need to use your disinfectant spray or your disinfectant wipes. It's optional what type of disinfectant spray, no preference in brand. I like to use the fragrant free, you guys know about that. It's always good to disinfect all hard top surf areas, including yourself, the apron that you apply on the client, and also the covers of your makeup product. And also it's good to have disinfectant wipe. Of course, you need to clean your area before you put your products on top, a clean sanitized area. And of course, you still need to sanitize all hard top safe area, including the chair, the handle of the chair, you know, and covers of your makeup palettes and brush tools. Then you need 70% alcohol, not more, nothing less. It have to be 70% alcohol. Most makeup artists do recommend that it's mandatory for you to have this alcohol. It's great disinfectant, your pressed powder or your cream powders as well, and it helps to proper sanitize in between clients. So for example, if you have a group of girls and you keep on reaching for the same palette all the time, or any eyeshadow palette, you always need to sanitize it with 70% alcohol. And no, it does not change the texture of your product, and it doesn't harm your product. It's only disinfect it, and it's quick dry. Then, of course, you need a reader, temperature reader. Of course, you need to show your clients you're doing their part. You already have all their booking information from the time you do a phone-to-phone, email, or booking app on your pages or any social media page. So you have all the information in place already. So the only thing that missing is for you to read their temperature and then write it down in your booking app that you have personally for yourself. And you need to have an apron for your clients. Some people, they don't. Most makeup artists, they definitely do. Exactly, I would say more for me because when you're working with a lot of glitters, loose pigments, and also setting powders and such, a lot of fallout is going to happen. And even if you try your best to stay away from the fallout on your client, you definitely need an apron. And every time I use an apron on a client, I normally take a napkin, put it around the cover, the neck area. So as soon as I remove the apron from the client, I throw away the tissue and then I spray my disinfectant spray on the apron. Then you need to have a brush cleanser. So basically, if you're a busy makeup artist, you always have clients walking in and out and you have a group of girls, you need to have a brush cleanser that is quick dry and you can use again. Like for example, the Benai, it's basically a solution. You pour it into the cup, you swirl your brush in it, wipe it on a clean napkin, and then leave it. It's honestly, it's quick dry. You can use it immediately, but I suggest that you leave it for just a couple more seconds before using it on the client. And yes, at the end of the day, you still have to wash your brushes. Basically, they come up with a solution to clean your brushes quickly so you can work after clients that come in after your booking. Or a better way, honestly, is to have disposable or enough makeup brushes. So instead of cleaning brushes in between clients, you separate your dirty brushes and your clean brushes, and then you keep using different brushes. So basically, if you have 10 girls, you have 10 foundation brush, 10 beauty blender, and so on. Then coming to what I just mentioned, you need to have a Ziploc bag. And basically, a Ziploc bag helps to put all your dirty equipment or tools, and you store it in a Ziploc bag, you zip it, and you separate it from your clean brushes. And also, another sanitation hygiene practice that you need to practice is also separate, once again, what I just mentioned, separate your clean brushes from your dirty brushes. Never mix the clean and the dirty together, because at the end of the day, you're gonna get confused and end up picking up a dirty brush that you use on one client and use it on the recent client that you have right now. So always separate your clean and your dirty brushes. Do not mix them. Put it in a Ziploc bag that I just mentioned. You need to have a metal plate. Now, the metal plate helps with mixing your foundations, your concealer, your lip products, whatever you want to mix. The metal plate helps with it, or a disposable plate like what I mentioned in my previous series, that it helps to mix it, all your liquid products. So before, once again, as I mentioned, back in the days, people used to use their hand. That was many years ago, but now they come up with the mixing plate, the disposable plate. Some people use the plastic wrap to mix any liquid products on your face with a spatula before they applied to their client's face. And once again, the metal plate is easy. You just wipe it with makeup remover wipes and disinfect it, or you can wash the metal plate or the plastic plate, or even better yet, the disposable plate. You can just throw it away. Now, the other point I want to bring across, of course, is having a bin. Have a small bin or a small little doggy bag. I call it doggy bag because it's that small plastic bag. And then you can carry your garbage with you. So, of course, you're going to use a brand new lash. You're not going to use the same lash that you use on a current client before. You're going to use a brand new lash. So, the package that comes with the lashes, you need to throw it away. So, throw it it in the bin. Anything that you use, like makeup remover wipes, cotton pad, Q-tip, when you sharpen your pencil, you need to have a bin. You throw all your garbage in that bin and not on top your workstation, your makeup setup, you know. And then once your job is done, once again, you take your bin or your garbage bag with you and then you go. Never leave your garbage wherever you are. If you are freelancing, makeup artist especially. Coming to the next point I want to bring across, of course, is a hand sanitizer for both you and your clients. Normally when I reach at a workstation, I ask them to use their sink. I wash my hands with soap water and dry it with napkin and throw my napkin in my bin. Or if there's a sink near you, of course, hand sanitizer to sanitize your hand and your client's hand, of course. Always remember, never forget to sanitize your client's hand. And also, whenever you sanitize in your hand, always turn around to make your client see that you are sanitizing your hand. And also, another point I want to bring across, I mean, it might not be that important to you, but it's to me, is having gum, breath mint, or something. Because once again, as I told you, when I first started out as a makeup artist, I was literally, you know, I feel like I took up and personal in a client's face, even if I have a certain distance applying makeup. So I was too up and personal in their face. So I always used to use gum and have my mask, of course. So have some type of gum and mint or breath mint or something, you know. So you want your clients won't feel too uncomfortable when you're applying their makeup for a whole hour, you know. And then also the last part I want to bring across is gloves. Now, some people find it very uncomfortable, makeup artists, to work with gloves. Some people use gloves, especially in times of COVID. People make gloves very mandatory. But to me, when you're using gloves, make sure you use gloves when you have a cut or plaster on your hand. If you have any cuts or plaster on your hand, it's a must that you use gloves. It's a must. No question asked. It's a must. If you don't have cuts or plaster on your hand, then it's okay. Just make sure you wash and sanitize your hand. But if you ever have cuts and plaster, you must. It's a must. You use gloves. All right, that's it on today's episode of Makeup Artist Advisory by Chanelie767. I hope that you enjoyed this video. Until the next time, keep it locked.